In this example, we're given the universal set contains the lowercase letters a through j with subsets a, b, and c. We want to determine the elements in the sets given here below. We just did a similar example using a Venn diagram. For this example, let's see if we can determine the elements in these sets by analyzing the subsets a, b, and c. So we first have a intersect with b union c. Notice how b union c is in parentheses. So we'll find this union first and then find the intersection of a and this union. So we'll begin by determining b union c. Because we have the union here, we're looking for the elements that are in set b or also in set c, which means we'll be combining the elements in b and c into one set. So here's b and c. Let's see if we can put these elements in alphabetical order. So we would have c, d, e, g, h, and j. These are the elements that are in b or in c. So now we want to find the intersection of A and this set. Let's list it out. The elements in A in alphabetical order would be C, E, H, I. We want to intersect this with B union C, which contains C, D, E, G, H, and J. So we're looking for the intersection, which means we're looking for the elements that are in this first set and also in the second set. So we're looking for the elements they have in common. Notice how they both contain C, as well as E, as well as H. And therefore, this set here contains these three elements. C, E, and H. We don't have to have these in alphabetical order, but I think it does make it easier to identify the intersection. Now for our second example, we have A intersect B union C. We'll first find A intersect B, and then we'll take that set and find the union with C. So first we want to find A intersect B, which would contain the elements that are in set A and also in set B. So looking at set A and B, we're looking for the elements in common, which would be H and E. But let's put these in alphabetical order. Let's list the elements as E and then H. So now we want to take this set and find the union with C. So we have E and H union set C, which is given here. Again, let's alphabetize this. So we have C, E, G, and J. We want the union of these two sets, meaning we want the elements in this set or this set. So we'll be combining these two sets into one. So we would have C, E, H, G, and J. I hope you found this helpful.